y'all wanted me to. I'm doing it. Okay, bye. The Grudge. I don't know what this dance move is. I would bring a bobblehead. Oh, I like the little drum in the back.
Like a crowd, negativity calculate what we will not tolerate, desperate to control all and everything, unable to forgive you, scarlet letter.
Okay, right off the bat, I'm already like, yes, I feel like a lot of people do wear their grudges like a crown. They wear them proudly. They feel like they're a part of their identity. They feel like having a grudge against someone means that you have power over them. And interesting, we love a Scarlet Letter reference. That was like the only classic novel that I actually really liked that I read in high school.
Negativity, calculate what we will not tolerate, desperate to control all
and everyone is desperate to control.
Scarlet Letter.
That was good. I like that. I love that little drum. Okay, this is interesting. Okay, Saturn ascends. Now, from my understanding of what Saturn represents, it's like taking radical responsibility, releasing the things that are not important and the things that you cannot control, and taking responsibility for the things that ours and are yours to control. Knowing Tool and their like vibe, I wouldn't be surprised if that's what Saturn Ascends is referencing. Like, this individual is coming up to their Saturn return, and it's like, you're an adult now. It's time to face the world differently. Oh, this is a long song. Oh, we're vibing. Okay, I didn't even notice. Let's go.
Saturn ascends, for one thought, ignorance.
damage done. And then we're like talking about wearing your grudge like a crown and how it's becoming defining, it's becoming confining, and it's causing you to sink deeper. Often, what I think is really interesting about grudges, we think we are being mad at someone for hurting us, for allowing something bad to happen to us, for contributing to our pain. But what we are actually doing is continuing that pain within ourselves. Okay, it sounds like the Beatles up in here. This is cool. I like this idea of what they're pointing to as having a choice point. Like right now, you are at a place, and I just want you to see that your grudge is holding you down, sinking you deeper, confining you. And Saturn, or this song in this case, is going to show you that. And then you get to choose what, if you're going to ignore that and keep on grudging, or if you're going to face it. Waters take it away, but if you're holding on to it as a grudge, then and you're like grounded, then the waters can't take it away and alchemize it into something new, can't transmute it into gold. So the song, I feel like, is calling you to make a choice of what you want to do with the grudge. Often when bad things happen to us, they happen to us because we didn't have a choice, or our choice was taken from us. Things like abuse, assault, neglect, betrayal. And so it is often that lack of having a choice that is part of the grudge. Now, in mindlessly holding a grudge against someone, we are also taking away choice in our life. We are also taking away opportunities for ourselves in our life. And if you want to mindfully hold a grudge and you see all of the things that it could cause, it could weigh you down, and you still are choosing that, that is a choice. And that's even a more powerful place than a mindless grudge, but it's not what I would suggest. It's not my recommendation. But even the act of this song pointing out that you get to choose is reclaiming a part of what was broken when the pain was created. And that is powerful. So when you listen to this song, I want you to see that you have a choice. I want you to reclaim the choice that was lost to you when something bad happened to you. And then I want you to choose. Make an informed choice on what you want next. I want you to choose, because that's what's powerful. When you choose, when you reclaim what was taken from you and you make a choice for your life, not for anybody else. Okay, that's just my two cents, but I know we have like a minute and a half left in the song, so let's listen to it. I did not mean to stop right before the breakdown. Exercise those demons, baby. Let it go.
Release.
Yeah, as you release, as you let go of your grudge, you can let it go like that. Like, let it out of you. That actually sounds very therapeutic. Oh, they're saying let it go. Let go, let go. Okay. Tool's telling you the choice to make. They're telling you what they think. And I'm giving you my recommendation, and you got a bunch of cheerleaders alongside you, but when you listen to this song, I want you to hear and see that you have a choice. And to allow us and the band to cheerlead you towards the direction that is probably going to be most fruitful in your life. Rip it, baby. Mm. And if you're having a hard time letting go, I want you to share in the comments. If you're holding on to a grudge and you see that it's weighing you down, it's impacting your life, I want you to share in the comments and tag at HeartSupport, and we will encourage you. We have had so many Tool fans open up about their struggles in the comments of our other video. And we want you, a Tool fan, to come alongside us and help us help those people. We believe that music connects people. You already have that connection of loving the same band. We'll train you by clicking the link below on how to volunteer and best support other fans in the Tool community. But we want you to help us help them. Love you. Click the link.